Hello everyone. Today, there is a very splendid scientific news. It is from Professor Stefano PIRAINO, University of Salento, Italy. My name is Shinkubota, Associate Professor of Kyoto University. I would like to introduce Professor Stefano PIRAINO. He has been studying biology of Hydrozoa, phylum Cnidaria, for a long time, and he recently found very fantastic, splendid scientific finding.
Well, thank you very much for this kind introduction. So in the last year, we were interested in working on the evolution of the nervous system, and the unexpected finding came from a small animal producing a very small larvae, and these very small larvae have a very different nervous system from what we know from zoology textbooks, where these animals are supposed to have just a simple web of nerve. That means that this is a first animal with a real brain in his body organization.
Well, this is the animal we have studied in the last years. In the A pictures, you see the colony of the hydroid that lives in the channel, in the English channel, in front of the Station Biologique de la SCOF in France. There are polyps which produce in colonies with male colonies that produce the sperms in the B pictures. In the C, you see the female colonies and female polyps producing the eggs attached to the polyp. And they, once they are fertilized, they develop, as followed with a D and E and F, the embryo development lead to the formation of elongated seagull-like larva that you see in the G and H, H pictures. Mm. Then, what we have found, looking at the anatomical organization of this nervous system of this animal, is that it's not composed by an interconnection of scattered nervous system, but the nerves are very polarized. The nervous system is very polarized in the anterior part of here. This is also the same, but it's facing down. This is the what we call the head of the larva, and this is also the head of the larva. With these are two different nerve cells, different with this different function and different chemical properties, which are organized in the anterior part, and they are there because the larva move crawling on the bottom like a worm, like a tadpole, which an undulating movement of the rest of the body. So this kind of anterior concentration of neurons, which are integrated at the base of the ectoderm of the larva, is a kind of brain-like structure. And this is, means that the genetic toolkit necessary to construct a centralized nervous system. Well, this is a real novelty because zoology textbooks usually describe cnidarians as radial animals, non-bilaterian animals, and lacking a brain-like structures. So we show here these animals have a larva which behave and have an anatomical organization like bilaterian animals, and especially with a brain-like structure.
Thank you, Professor PIRAINO. I never heard of such a very fantastic finding. Another story, it's also a very fantastic story. He treats an immortal Hydrozoa, one of the most miracle animals in the world among the multicellular animals. The name is Turritopsis.
The story is really amazing. It was looking at a small animal, a small jellyfish, which was left in a small vessel in the laboratory on the weekend. And on Monday morning, when we came back to the laboratory, there was no more jellyfish in the tank, but there was a small polyps. Usually, in the all animal beings, when there is a sexual reproduction, this is a one way to death. So after sexual reproduction, once or more times, then there is a way to death. But these animals was able to reverse the life cycles and to go back, even after sexual reproduction, go back to the polyp, that is a kind of larva or post-larva stage, an intermediate stage in the life cycle. This is very important because the jellyfish has been called, as you say, a kind of immortal animal, but of course it's not immortal at all, otherwise all the oceans would be filled by these jellyfish. What is true is that the jellyfish, this animal, has the potential to change the state of differentiation of his cells for some part of his life. So there is the ability to switch on or switch off some molecular controls that allow the jellyfish to go back to the polyp stage. And some cells to gain again a kind of a multipotent state of differentiation. Near future, to have a genome available from sequences from this species to understand in detail what can be the molecular controls under which allow the cells to go back and let's say in a kind of rejuvenation, cell rejuvenation. And we have now a simple model that can be used to have a better understanding of this fundamental process for general biology and developmental biology. Another interesting lesson that we can learn from the so-called immortal jellyfish is that it's really worth to investigate much more on biodiversity than what was done in the past. Because the discovery of these jellyfish was just by chance. And we cannot discover fantastic things if we all just look at what we are looking for. It's always necessary to look forward and to look at the enormous diversity of living things and living beings. So we do not, it would be better not to stick too much on model systems, model organisms that can be cultivated or reared in the laboratory. Of course they are very important because the progress of cell biology, molecular biology and developmental biology need to have a supply of experimental material which must be genetically homogeneous. But then we need also to explore the variety and the diversity of the organisms. So it's very important that we have an open mind to look also at more different and different model organisms. Not only one representative for each phylum. Not only Hydra for the cnidaria, not only Drosophila for the insect, not only zebrafish for the fishes.
Very interesting story, and it's a very human being miracle is conquered. I heard he's now an organizer of Hydrozoan Society, that seventh international workshop.
The workshop will be very interesting because there will be people from all over the world attending the workshop to study all these interesting animals.
Yes. Thank you very much for your nice story and nice studies. Thank you very much.
And thank you to you and very good luck for your program.